we have good, fun step-by-step instructions. If most of you have already tried and played with TopHat a little bit already, though, I picked up on. So we probably don't need to go through this, and I'd much rather spend the time with the Q&A and talking about some of the issues and thoughts that we had. So for example, the presenter tool that floats over the Microsoft PowerPoint here, the Mac version of it, we could not get to work at all yesterday, except with Google Slides right next to it. And it was, I remember the same thing happened last spring, a year ago now, when Ed Hubbard was in and we were trying to set up for that. It wasn't working then either.
Were you loading it on to your computer directly or on a drive?
On the computer directly.
Okay. I've had that happen and I end up downloading it and putting it on a flash drive and it works.
That's weird.
And they tell me, well, sometimes it doesn't want to find it, but if you put it on the flash drive, it knows where it is, and that's how it, I mean, that's what worked for me.
Wow.
It shows up. It's just that whenever I click on it to expand it or to not expand it, it gets out of presentation mode, and then I've got I think it was what you were describing happened last year.
Okay.
With the PC version.
It's falling behind, okay.
So, and it might just, and maybe the newest version of Microsoft Office, which I think I do have that.
I also do find they do updates, and that's probably a weakness, they don't announce it,
mm-hmm.
and if you don't go back and pick them up, sometimes you start getting issues. All of a sudden it's like, well, what happened? Oh, have you downloaded the new software? No. That's it.
Yeah. Okay.
Question?
After class, do you go to review or show, or which toggle do you put your questions on after, like to allow them to see what the right answer is? Do you change it to review so that they can then use that later?
Or what I do is I actually keep them closed initially, and then just before the exam I'll go back and open everything up for review.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
I got it.
Yes.
I just started playing around with TopHat, but I've had a lot of technical issues, and I've been working with them because at the first, I was willing to throw it out the window.
Mac or PC?
PC.
Okay.
They say also on Internet Explorer, this is very funky. Is that true? Because then I have to warn my students, don't use Internet Explorer, which I wasn't. I was in Firefox. But the first question they asked me was, are you using Internet Explorer? Because it doesn't really work that way.
Yeah.
So the case? Because that's something I need to tell everybody, don't use Internet Explorer.
A good rule of thumb for most software,
don't use Internet Explorer.
Use Internet Explorer.
I was going to say, a good rule of thumb for life.
I know, I never use it, because
they now have single sign-on with your MyUW, it's sort of automatically going to Firefox, typically.
Okay.
And that's what I'm finding on the PC. They're doing the single sign-on thing now, and it's getting around that problem, because I had glitches last year, too.
I just didn't know if that was one more thing that had to go in the syllabus, make sure you're not on Internet Explorer. But the sign-in you're saying is going right through.
Yeah, because now it'll say, okay, what's your UW sign-in? And you no longer have to do this separate thing. And then it hooks you through there, and my UW always hooks up with Firefox. It doesn't hook up with Internet Explorer. So that just made it like one step simpler.
Okay.
But,
as long as that's not
I must have been
something that one.
Did
we have
provided they have Firefox.
Firefox. Yeah.
Then I have one other question, because at the moment, and I've only been a week on the job here, playing with this,
mm-hmm.
I've been uploading my PowerPoints
mm-hmm.
to this. So you don't upload your PowerPoints.
No.
You just enter PowerPoint and it automatically?
No, I open two things. I open a PowerPoint like I would on a laptop, and then this is actually on the hard drive. There's a folder, and I just say Top Hat, and it loads the widget.
Okay.
And it just pops it right on top. Again, though, I'm really intrigued by loading it and doing the whole presentation tool. If you don't have to make...
I don't have that many videos that switch. So
and videos that switch, they'll need
to
help you, though, get those videos in there. But if you don't have that, that could give you a lot more flexibility and fewer glitches, I would think.
They also mentioned that the transitions and animations don't work in that mode either.
Yeah,
so as long as the slides are static,
like
PDF almost.
And I'm their worst nightmare because I change videos all the time. I have four or five or six. I mean, it's marketing, right?
Yeah.
So you've got a lot of video.
Amy?
I'm curious about uploading your PowerPoints and how that's worked for you, because I tried uploading one yesterday and there were no animations on it, but It uploaded the first slide and then like one letter at a time up to half a sentence of the second slide and then none of the rest of the presentation.
That's right, I remember that.
I had problems with everything else. The only thing I didn't.
Well, something to look forward to then.
Everything else was
PC
working.
PC or Mac?
Mac.
I think that there are some issues with just execution in Mac, and that's probably a conversation for them.
Because I have a Mac and I upload my slides. It takes a few minutes, so bing, 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 and then it'll upload. So, but
it said it uploaded.
It did say
uploaded. It said it was uploaded, but then when I went to play it, it just was not there.
Oh, interesting. Well, maybe they could do a screen share with you and see what, you know.
And also, are you using PowerPoint or Keynote?
PowerPoint.
Okay. Did you use PowerPoint or Keynote? PowerPoint.
Do you use that discussion board?
No, but I have some ideas as to how I might integrate it. And I'm not sure if it's plausible yet. We're trying to figure it out.
So what I was thinking about doing is obviously having the discussion board open, and then I'm one of the TAs, so being able to be active in class. But if you don't have a TA, I think it might be challenging to like provide real-time feedback, but I'm hoping it'll work for us.
Yeah, the discussion board is supposed to be able to give you real-time discussion, and then you can see questions that are coming up. And this past couple of years, I haven't had, none of my ATAs have been able to make this a live lecture. Oh. So I wasn't able to give lecture and do that. I think in a small class, it would work pretty well. In a large class, you don't want to throw it up top. There's too much anonymity and ability for people to troll live in class. So I wouldn't do that. I'd have a TA looking at it small and telling me what some of those key things were.
Yeah. That was what I was thinking of using, as I might have been about 109 students. Mm-hmm. But then I got TAs with discussions, open up a discussion at the end of the lecture, leave it open so the TAs can look at it and see the ideas and then bring that into the discussion section.
That's a piece of what I'm thinking of trying. I haven't tried it, but for next semester we had to reconfigure. I'm actually wondering if there's a way to do groups within the lecture, have them do some things, and then have TAs access those groups in the discussion and leverage off of that.
That would be interesting if you could divide them up into groups so that.
Well, and they are in groups, they have discussion groups already, which would happen. And so now they would, all those group members have to be in the same lecture now by structure. In theory, it could work. I don't know. That's my project for the summer, is to figure out if that's something we can get going. And I'd love to talk to you about how your plan is going, because I'm trying to tighten up the links between lecture and discussion and what they're doing and how they're